Welcome, geniuses. I'm Genie, your best buddy for A-levels. In this channel, we'll bring you to explore the secret formula behind success.
Hello, geniuses. Today we have a familiar face, or should I say voice, with us again. Aldrich was previously featured in our video about university applications, where he talked in length about his experience applying for Cambridge, which you can find in our playlist. With that in mind, I'm going to skip the usual introductions, so let's just get into it.
Hello everyone, again, my name's Aldrich, and welcome to this video.
So, let's start with the standard question. How exactly did you manage to make zero mistakes in your paper and achieve a perfect score of 100 marks for math?
I think that mathematics is all about understanding the concepts in each topic learned and constantly practicing past year papers to ensure that you know how to apply those concepts in various questions. And those are the work before the examination. The work during the examination is as important. So during the examination, it's all about maintaining your composure and trusting yourself. I cannot stress enough to check through your workings, and if the time allows, redo those questions that you're unsure of on another piece of paper. Compare your answers if they're the same, and if they're not, well, you better redo that question again.
What resources and books did you use to aid in your revision?
So I only studied my teacher's notes and used a few textbooks when studying mathematics. So the textbooks that I use are actually Advanced Level Statistics by Jay Crawshaw and Jay Chambers, and Understanding Mechanics by A.J. Sattler and D.W.S. Tawning. And for pure mathematics, I do use this book sometimes, but not often, is Introducing Pure Mathematics by Robert Smedley and Gary Wiseman. So all these textbooks are extremely useful to try to understand difficult concepts that maybe your teacher has taught you, but you don't really understand. And another thing about using textbooks is that mathematics textbooks sometimes are really dry, so it's best to break it up into chapters and then only focusing on certain topics that you do not understand. Don't try to digest the whole textbook in, sometimes it doesn't work, but if it works for you, well, that's fine. However, I do think that the syllabus has changed quite a bit since my time, so it is better if you ask your teacher about the books that you should purchase or should borrow from the library. As long as a book can make you understand a particular topic well, then you'll do. For most of the time, I just do plenty of past year papers to make sure that I grasp the concept well. And for A-levels, this works particularly well because the questions are quite repetitive sometimes.
How did you schedule your revision process?
I think if you really want a good score in mathematics, you really have to do a few questions each day to keep your mind fresh. I usually do one or two past years per day. If not, just a few questions on uncomfortable topics. I will list down the few questions which I struggle on or find interesting and revise them again before the exam.
Do you take notes for math?
So it varies from person to person. I'm not a note-taking person, so I don't really take any notes for mathematics, in fact. The most that I do is actually print out the data booklet for mathematics and write down some important concepts or important formulas that I have to remember before the examination. And before I go in, I just flip it through to make sure that I understand every single thing that I need to understand. And if you're a note-taking person, make sure that you organize your notes correctly and efficiently so that before the examination, you wouldn't struggle to find important topics or concepts that you want to revise on.
Before we move on to our next part, would you kindly offer some last-minute tips to our geniuses?
The best is to constantly revise, especially for mathematics, and you should be fine. The most important thing, I think, to do is to keep calm and maintain your composure before going into the exam. Panicking or worrying will only make things worse. Look through the formulas once again. Make sure that you understand all the topics and you'll be alright.
How did you manage your time to ensure excellence in all subjects?
So, I'm a person who believes in timetables and progress checks for each topic that you're weak in. A simple to-do list each day and being disciplined in completing it. Take note of the things that you're weak in and put more effort into it. Don't be afraid to fail the first time. It's better to fail when you're revising and not during the examination itself. I prefer to study 3 hours a day with 10 minutes of break for each 30 minutes of effort put into it. Well, it works for me, but I believe that everyone has their own style of studying or own method in organizing their own study. So find out the web method that works the best for you and make sure that you're in an environment which is comfortable so that you can absorb the knowledge better.
What were the strategies and techniques you used to tackle all these different subjects?
For maths and further maths, you basically have the same strategy. You look through the topics and concepts, revise them, work through the past years, and go through those questions which you got wrong when you are doing the past years, or even those which you struggle at. Take note of those formulas, revise it through, keep calm, go into the exam, do it, you should be fine. For physics, it's even more important to understand all the concepts within it and also the equations that come with it. I find YouTube videos particularly helpful in understanding those difficult concepts because they illustrate it well for you. As for economics, I generally listen to all the explanations given by my teachers, as well as making side notes for important words that I could use in essays. Another great platform to learn economics is actually Khan Academy, as well as Crash Course, because of the illustrations and explanations you can easily incorporate it into your essays. When revising, I would browse through topics, past year topics, for the essay questions and make skeletons for those essays so I could sort of mix and match the different concepts that I have learned for a different essay that I encountered during the examination. This works because I don't have to rethink of all the points that I want to write into my essays. It's pretty simple, and I'm pretty sure that everyone could do this in their spare time, just writing down a couple of main points that you would like to point out in every single essay question. You don't have to actually write down an entire essay, as it would be quite time consuming in fact.
And do you have any last minute tips?
So the last tip that I would like to give you guys is not much of a study tip, but a tip to keep yourself healthy. Sleep well and eat well. Don't stress yourself out. A healthy body provides you a healthy mind. It's normal to feel nervous, but just try your best to keep calm and trust in your own revision. A calm mind when going into the examination is key to performing at a better standard. And, well, all the best to all of you guys.
And finally, do you have anything you would like to say to your audiences before we end today's video?
It's not impossible to achieve the grades that you want and get into the university that you dream. It requires a lot of hard work and dedication. But I'm sure that with the right study, as well as the effort put into it, you guys will get what you guys want, and you guys will make it to the top in the end. Good luck!
Thank you so much, Aldrich. It's good seeing you again.
You're welcome, Genie.
That's all for today's video. If you're interested in more genuine sharing by other geniuses, please subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell, ding dong. Genie, we'll see you in our next adventure. Bye-bye!